Hey guys, my name is Zabo, and welcome to The Zabo, and today we're going to be reacting to Con Daniel's last album that he's released so far. Yes, the Yellow album, and yeah, it has 5 songs in it, so that means we're just going to do all 5, because if it had 6, you know, I would have done part 1 and part 2, but since it has 5, we're going to do all 5 of them. So, the first song we're starting off with is Digital. I did not see nothing for Digital. I looked, I made sure, I checked his channel. I didn't see anything for Digital. Next one is, after Digital, is Paranoia. So, yeah. You guys have been spamming that song, Paranoia. When is Paranoia coming out? And, yeah, we're finally here. We're finally getting to Paranoia. And the next one is called Misunderstood. I didn't see, like a good quality color-coded lyrics one for Misunderstood, so we're just going to react to it like off of Spotify so I can get the best sound. Like this one, I listened to it like 5 seconds in and it sounded, you know, good. It sounded fine. It sounded like, you know, muffled or whatever. But the other ones just sounded bad for Misunderstood for some reason to me. And then next we have Antidote. Since I already seen the Antidote music video, I thought it would just be fine for me to react to the dance practice. Because I've seen the music video. I mean, it was kind of a bad quality video, yes. And this was before the quality got better. But it wouldn't be like a true reaction. And I didn't even watch any of the dance practice for Antidote. I saw the music video, heard the song, but didn't even think about watching the dance practice. So I get to see the dance, like I actually get to see the choreography that was implemented into that music video. And then lastly, we'll end the song off. I think the name of this last song is called Save You, I think. But we'll see. Basically, I'm just trying to do it as memory as possible, but we'll see. So the first song we have is Digital. I apologize if I didn't see anything. I looked. I made sure. It took me a while just to set up the video because I wanted to make sure I find all his dance practices or performances or anything that is related to the song that is like kind of live or kind of just shows the music. You know, I looked and I didn't see anyone for Digital. But yeah, without further ado, make sure to like this video, comment any more Con Daniel like stuff down below. I think after this album, I saw some singles on Spotify. We're gonna see if there's any like music videos or any performances for those, and I will react to those singles. I think there's one with Zico. I think that's the name of the artist. I saw that one. Like I'll react to those singles, and then that will be it. That will be literally all the Con Daniel like stuff that he's produced or been a part of. And after that, I think I'll give him like my top 5 Con Daniel songs that I enjoyed, and then we'll just react to like, I guess, like maybe like moments of his so I can learn more about him, like funny moments or this happened with, you know, just after that, because I do want to keep Con Daniel on the channel because I think he's very, very good and a very good person and artist. So I want to keep him on the channel. So yeah, subscribe, trying to get 300 subscribers. And I've seen a lot of love for these Con Daniel videos. Like each video that I posted basically has over 100 likes, and I'm like, wow, you guys really love this man. And like 1,000 views, I'm like, yeah, I can see this man gets a lot of love, and the fans are supporting new people that, you know, are coming to him. So let's get into Digital. 3, 2, 1, let's go. Okay, as always, experimenting with stuff. Why does this give me the Weeknd vibes before the Weeknd came out? Like, this song gives me the Weeknd vibe. I didn't expect the song to go that way. I
조금씩 무뎌지는 감각 어느 순간 익숙해진 앞엔 결국엔 I'm on easy brain 이 손끝에 피어나는 사이 스쳐 지난 순간 불길이 터져 지워지지 않았던 거짓을 뿌린 그곳에 핀 날카로워진 가시가 터진 곳
That's such a good song. And so, like, as like you guys been saying, that he loves to experiment with a lot of his music, and that just gave me like video game vibes of like, I guess, in like a shooter type game, like running out there. Like I could see that being part of like a trailer or something, you know, like of a shooter game of any, you know, type. I could just see that. And I was trying to read the lyrics, but then I got lost in the music. Like, it's almost like I was reading it, but not like really focused on it. You know, when you read something or like is told to read something that's for school, and you're just reading it mindlessly, but not like taking it in and being like, okay, I read that. Now, how does that make me feel? Or, you know what I mean? When you like maybe read a page or two, then you're like, what was I just reading? Or you just read something, but didn't comprehend, like, you're not comprehending it. That's basically what I was reading the lyrics, but I wasn't comprehending it, because I was just listening to the song and enjoying, like, that, like, kind of, like, weird, like, kind of eerie almost, but futuristic beat. That's why I said I compared it to The Weeknd, because, you know, The Weeknd's, you know, futuristic song came out, like, almost like 80s, 90s, disco-type beat. That's what it gave me, like, kind of almost like a disco-type beat, but more futuristic, like, in the future. Yeah, I like this song a lot, digital. Yeah, let us move on to the next song, which is Paranoia. The song that you got, let me make sure to turn the volume up on it. But, yeah, you guys have been spamming this, and I'm finally here watching Paranoia. So, without further ado, 3, 2, 1, let's go. I got the lyrics there, but I'm telling you for sure, I'm not reading none of that. Am I just crazy or dreaming awake? I can't escape. Make sure my head right. Oh, why? No. Yeah. helpful. And then the rap part right there. Kind of speechless. That's not the right song, but I'm kind of speechless on what I just saw. that was Paranoia by God Daniel. Wow, you guys were right. That was like the whole demonic thing, let me get that out the way. Like that was dope to me. I like that. Like I guess I should say I'm not like full like Christian like that. Like I'm not like, oh my god, dude, can't watch this, killing my kids. No. I'm fine with everything and anything. That song, like the choreography looked dope. The whole like I'm trying to figure out what the story is about. Like, God, let me know what paranoia is about. I mean, yeah, being paranoia is like, you know, about being, I guess, paranoid about something. But I couldn't figure out what the message. Maybe at the end he explained it with the way the word failure was crossed out in his blood. Like, maybe he's paranoid about failing, so he's trying to like cross it out. But it's so hard to cross it out of his mind that he's starting to bleed. I don't know. I'm just making like a reference to the only thing that I can make a reference to, like the paranoia, like because it basically is talking about that feeling. Like they're always right behind, like the thing that you're paranoid about is always right there behind you, and you're, no matter what you're doing, it could just creep out of nowhere, and it just like makes you feel that emotion or that way. And I don't know if that's what he's talking about, like what he's going through or what he's been through. I don't know if that's what it means at the end with failure, like paranoia at this point with the word failure or just failing is so like makes him so paranoid that it's starting to maybe hurt him a little bit, or it hurts or it's hurting. And I don't know if, you know, that's what he's trying to say. I don't know. Just let me know, because I'm so curious about it. Like, that was such a mind-blowing song itself, too. Like, the beat was so cool. His vocals, the rap. That's why I said this man is a one-in-a-million hit. Like, no one can do it like him. No one's like him. And, like, any other solo artists are like that's why I love the solo artists in K-pop, because no one is like any of them. They may share some similarities, but they all are different in their own unique way. And they made going solo work out perfectly. Oh, I can't wait to add these songs to my playlist. Next song we have is Misunderstood. Let's just get right into it. 3, 2, 1, let's go. Featuring Omega Sapien.
It's a jail. 난 어둠 속에 갇혀진 듯해. 어떤 말들도 의미 없는데. 또 지독한 현실이 시작돼. 조각나고 비틀린 진실. Keep me awake. Round and round 날 가둬두는 너. 정해진 듯 끄어진 선 위. Uncover
I go again. 잠시 눈을 감은 채 가만히 나를 비웠네. I'm forever, ever, forever misunderstood. 무시해 what they say. Story goes round and round. Fake smiles all over my face. Black tinted windows down. 내가 뭘 어째 숨고 싶은 건 당연한 건데 need to find my way but I stay instead. The devil is a lie see them shades of red. Whoa. 짙은 안개가 깔리는 듯해 작은 속삭임 나를 뒤감아 끊어낼 수조차 없는 내게 not a ride a ride a ride I'm not okay.
I'm sorry. Different, but it just felt like I was like just thinking about, like, I mean, this is called Misunderstood, but he says I'm forever misunderstood, and I feel like that happens a lot to all of us. Like, there's like one thing that we're always like misunderstood about, like maybe how we feel about a certain thing or how we feel about this and that. I wonder if that's what he's talking about. Like the things and people in our personal lives or just in general, the things that we're misunderstood about. Like, oh, this person does this or does that. And that's not the case. It's just there's something happened. I feel like today especially, like you could be misunderstood for a lot of things, like, you know, cancel culture. Like you could be misunderstood and say something, but you don't mean that. You don't even mean to have said it like that, but people took it in the, you know, wrong way and misunderstood you, or just like in friends and family and stuff about your views and stuff, or they might not understand, you know, they misunderstood you about, like, you know, things. And I wonder if that's what he's talking about, because sometimes I feel that way with like how I feel about certain things, like K-pop especially. Like, I noticed, like, as soon as I got into K-pop, I noticed the amount of people that, like, love to hate on it, love to dislike it and stuff. And I feel like I might have been part of that group of just disliking it. I never hated it, I just maybe disliked it at first and, like, joined the trend. But once I finally got into it, I just learned a lot, like, to be open, to not really follow the trend, do my own thing, and look where it's gotten me. It's gotten me to Con Daniel, gotten me a lot of like reactions to different K-pop groups, and I even got my own little like mini series with Bandmade, like Bandmade Mondays too. Like this is my own series, and like a lot of people don't even do that. J-rock or J-pop. It's a J-Rock group. It's J-Pop. J-Rock. They don't even do, like, a lot of J-Rock or react to full albums, like, I feel like, as I do. Like, I'm reacting to full albums, not just like one title track song, a dance practice and a performance, and then that's it, and then I'll listen to the songs off on my own. No, I'm giving you my full reaction to all the songs. So I can see where this song, like, we all misunderstood each other, but we also get misunderstood as a person as well. So very deep song for me interpreting it that way, but I hope you guys understand. I like to try to my best to interpret the music emotionally on how I think it's being portrayed. So that's how I portray it. But yeah, on to Antidote. I love the song. I'm just gonna get that out there. I've heard the song, saw the music video, but we're doing the dance practice, so I hope this is good enough for you guys. But yeah, without further ado, let us begin. 3, 2, 1, let's go. Why do I just notice the females? Like, I feel like I don't see that many females in his like kind of dance videos. But this is dope so far. Oh, that's dope. That's a dope day. Ripple. I'm assuming that's what it's called. Ripple. I'm sorry for pausing, but the part where all the like the women like kind of clawing at him just reminded me of like the song like Antidote. Like, it's almost like the stuff that's like trying to make you toxic and whatever, or you know, whatever's trying to put you down, because it looked like they were trying to push him down, and like he just breaks out saying, "I need the antidote to get out of this mess." Like, almost like the choreo, you know, the choreo matches the song, and I like that. I like it when the choreo matches like what the song is saying. Ooh, all the synchronization.
Thank you.
So that was Antidote on the dance party. Basically, I think that choreography just fits like the song itself. Like when he this that was the first song I heard ever by Con Daniel was Antidote, and that really got me into him. And I saw so much support for the Antidote video that I had to do more of him. And as I went through this journey of learning who Con Daniel is through his music, like I said, he's one in a million, but he also speaks with, without having to use words, he speaks with his dance too. Like his choreography is, matches the song, the flow. Like with Antidote there, it's just, the dance felt like, as he was dancing, I saw one part where like the girls was turning his face to look that way, the guy was turning it back, like, oh, turn this way. He put his hand on you, and the other dude like swapped it down, like, put your hand, like, you know, almost like he's being controlled, like almost like the things that he wants to do, like the people, not the people, but the things around him aren't letting him be himself. And he wants an antidote, basically a way to express himself, be himself, without these things controlling that and making him do something or be something or say, or, you know, basically do something that he doesn't want to do. And I feel like this song is like just expressing that, like I want to be able to do stuff the way that I want to do things, and or keep doing the stuff that I want to keep doing the way that I want to do it. And that's why he's looking for an antidote, because maybe at this point in time, or there's moments and times where he feels like he needs some, like an antidote to get out. Like I feel like maybe, like which we all go through, like there's a time in our life where like we feel like we're stuck in some kind of maybe cycle, or just stuck in some type of day-to-day thing where like we have no control over it, and it feels like the cycle will never break, and it's like you're almost like just open for something different, something new, like an, like something just refreshing. And I feel like maybe that's him sometimes, like maybe he feels like he's stuck in some type of loop sometimes, and he just look at, and like this is his way of expressing that feeling. And I think it's just a great song, because we all gone through that where we're kind of stuck in like a loop or some kind of chaotic like thing where we can't escape it, and we're looking for that antidote to get away from it, or like, you know, be cleaned of it, I guess. This is why I like this song a lot, because it gets me kind of feeling that way. I mean, like, because I do feel that way sometimes when I'm like looking for an antidote, like a way to get out of that feeling, or a way to get out of the certain loop that I feel. And when I first heard this song, I felt that way. And now that I'm hearing it for the second time, like with a reaction for the second time, I've listened to it multiple times, but with the reaction and seeing the dance, the choreography for it, it makes sense why the choreography matches the music so well. He just does a great job of that. And the last song we have is Save You. And this will be the last song for the Yellow album. Sad times, I know, but I finally got to you guys' request of Paranoia and the Yellow album. After this, it will be done for CMY, and apparently there's a K album coming out for Black, so I don't know about that, but I can't wait for the future of Con Daniel to come out with more stuff. I will be on, like, I will have his notifications, bell, everything. So let's get on. This is the only thing I could find that was, like, live. And that was, I guess, the full song. Because there was some other stuff, but it wasn't, like, the full song on his channel. I looked at, like, the song comparisons, and it wasn't the full song. So we'll just do this version. So, yeah. Save You. By Con Daniel featuring, I think that's Winston. I think that said Winston. Minston. Did it say Winston or Minston? Wanstein. Wanstein. I'm stupid. Wanstein. Okay, I apologize. Wanstein. Save You by Con Daniel featuring Wanstein. Let's begin. 3, 2, 1, let's go.
Taga una domina, we're okay. 같으면 every day to save you
save
every day to save you
yeah
모든 게 무너져도 너를 잃지 마 cause every day to save you
save you
every day to save you
save yeah
I promise 내가 갖고 올게 미래 비전 이건 네가 써둔 편지 읽기 전 돈을 벌고 나면 전부 해결될 거라고 믿었지 어렸던
나한테 달랐어
disgusting way 아픔을 말해줘 애써 웃어 보이려 하지마 길고 긴 길을 걸어 just not a love day just not a love day
이유 없이 불안한 날들 뒤돌아보면 just let it I'll be there yeah 차가운 어둠이 널 외롭게 가두면 I'll be there to save you I'll be there to save you 모든 게 무너져도 너를 잃지 마 Cause I'll be there to save you I'll be there to save you yeah. 기다리면 올 세상일까 아님 시계조차 미각을 주저하는 걸까 고장난듯 여전히 전부 멈춘 시간이 익숙해져 버렸나 안개가 적해진 밤 아직은 불투명 없음 머지않아도 You're stronger than you think you are
모든 것이 버거울
때만
좀 쉬어가도 괜찮아 I'll be there, I'll be there
차가운 어둠이 널 외롭게 I'll be there to save you I'll be there to save you 모든 게 무너져도 너를 잃지 마 Cause I'll be there to save you I'll be there to save you
I like the smile. Yeah. That was Con Daniel's Save You song at the end. What did I think about it? Good song. Like, especially the one Sting guy. I didn't think he was, like, both. Like, I saw that he was a rapper. But he's also a singer. I mean, I should expect this of K-pop. If you're a rapper, you can also sing too. Like, you're also a vocal. Like, I seen the surprise mix of that with Dreamcatcher. Now I expect every rapper in K-pop to have a bit of singing or vocals in the group, maybe. Unless they're really known not to sing and they're just there as like a rapper. And that's well known, then that's well known. But for groups that I might not know that are rappers, I might as well expect them to be a rapper and vocalist secretly too, like, you know. But that song was very good. I think what that song was about, basically being by someone's side, being by the person that you love's side, and being there when, you know, when they need you. Like, he's talking about, I'll be there, I'll be right beside you, I'll be there to save you. Like, basically, and it kind of had like almost like that choir type feeling with the, like the vocals at the one part where there's I think talking about saving you, like almost like we're like I got you, like I'm gonna be here if you need anything, I'll save you from whatever like you're feeling, darkness, sadness, loneliness, like I will be there to be your light and say, like, you know, I feel like that's what they were talking about with the song. But yeah, that song, I would say that's a great way to end this kind of almost like roller coaster of emotions of a song, like going through paranoia, being misunderstood, and looking for like an antidote. This is the best like a song to end it. And like at the beginning, I don't know what Digital is about, so I won't mention that, but you guys can let me know to tie it all in for the beginning part of it with Digital at the beginning. But at the end, someone is going to be there to save you, or he's talking about also himself too, like there's this one person that will be there right beside me to save me when I need the help the most. So just a great song, just a great album, great song, great like just album to have to listen to if you need like the song. Like I feel like I would listen to this song and maybe cry. Like I listen to it not thinking about those emotions, but I feel like if I'm in that deep dark place and I listen to this song, I feel like this would be like a nice song to cry. It'd be sad, but to cry to, and you know, get me into the right thing of who to call or who to talk to about this problem. So shout out to Con Daniel. Shout out to all the Danities. I'm a Danity now, but shout out to all the Danities that have showed lots of love to my videos. Like, really lots of support for this man who, he needs to be seen more. But I mean, if that's not what he wants to do, then that's not what he wants to do. Because he's clearly making music that he wants to make and getting the support that he wants to get, you know? So shout out to Con Daniel, Danities. You guys are very strong, have a very fantastic artist that you follow and look up to, and I can't wait for his next album to come out. I'm part of this fandom now, and just like I said, leave comments down below what you thought about this album and all his other songs, and just, you know, just tell me what you think. Subscribe, trying to get 300. Thank you guys so much. I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.